Cryotherapy is a great option for some patients with prostate cancer. I find cryotherapy works best in two groups. There is the group that has local disease where there is a nodule that you can either see or feel, and that's the only place that shows up on the prostate biopsy. We call that focal therapy. The rest of the prostate is left untreated and you only treat that spot. The other time that I think cryotherapy is an ideal treatment is someone who has had radiation treatment in the past that has failed. So somebody's had radiation, whether it be brachytherapy or external beam therapy, and their PSA starts to rise. They don't have metastatic disease, they get another biopsy, and we find living cancer cells in their prostate. That person can't have more radiation. That person has a difficult time with a radical prostatectomy because of complications. Cryotherapy is an ideal treatment in that patient before going on to systemic treatment like hormone therapy.
Some prostate cancers are high risk, aggressive, and more likely to spread. Others are low risk, least likely to have bad outcomes. The biopsy says cancer, but current diagnostic tools provide limited information about how aggressive a man's individual disease is. So most men decide to treat prostate cancer immediately. Once treated, many men experience serious long-term side effects, like incontinence and sexual impotence. Immediate treatment isn't always needed, but right now a man can't be sure if his cancer is the kind that is likely to require treatment or if he's okay to wait for now. What if there was a test that could determine how aggressive prostate cancer is? Genomic Health is developing a new test to do just that. By reviewing the underlying biology of the tumor and using genes from multiple biologic pathways, the test can predict the aggressiveness of prostate cancer when diagnosed, allowing a man to make a more informed treatment decision with confidence, taking care of himself with more information and greater peace of mind.